this instrument is called as plasma discharge globe. This plasma discharge globe is a very interesting instrument because it looks like sparks are coming out from the center of this ball. This glass bulb is having a very special construction. Inside this glass bulb, there is vacuum, and if I touch this, I get some spark coming to my body, because in that vacuum, there is inert gas like helium, neon, argon, or mixture of those gases is filled. And if the central electrode has very high voltage and very high frequency, then we can get plasma discharge. Plasma is a fourth state of matter in which the positive and negative ions are in very high energy states. And here we are getting these sparks coming out from the center because the discharge comes from high voltage towards the low voltage, that is surrounding bulb and air. If I touch this, I will not get any shock, but the spark is getting attracted towards my finger. Now, why the spark is getting attracted towards my finger? Because my body is a better conductor than the surrounding air. Surrounding air is poor conductor, but my body is somewhat better conductor. So the charges always go toward the low resistive path. Now we can see some interesting experiment. Suppose I bring a tester near it, I get glow. This tester is showing a glow that indicates it is very high voltage or high current, something here, but it is not like that. Actually, when tester glows, we have a fear that if I touch, I'll get shock, but I don't get shock here because when the current is going in my body, that current is very, very small. Now, how much small current? Say some microamperes, and that also is AC, alternating current. So microampere current is not dangerous for our body. Our body can very easily stand for some microampere current. Even up to 100 microampere, there is no danger. Above that, we can get shock. Okay. Now here, if I bring this tester near, I get glow. But even if I bring this tester like this, it also glows. Now the question is, why this glows? Also, we can have one more interesting experiment where I'm bringing tube light near this glow. I see that the tube light is glowing. Now, why the tube light is glowing? We'll find the answer. We'll discuss the answer for this. This tube light is glowing, and even if I hold this light here, now only half of the tube light is glowing, and half is not glowing. And if I hold like this, this half is glowing. Now, one may ask question, why this part is not glowing and why this part is only glowing? I can tell in brief that my body has a shielding effect on this discharge. If you ask the question, what is inside this tubelet? Why the tubelet glows? What is inside the tester? Why the tester glows? I can give the answer in nutshell. In this tester, there is a neon bulb, and that neon bulb is getting energy excitation from this globe. So what actually happens is, inside this tubelet also, there is a mercury vapor in vacuum, and this tubelet has a white powder coating. That white powder coating is also very, very important, because when mercury atoms are getting energy from this ball in the form of, say, photons, the electrons in mercury atom, they jump from the inner orbit to outer orbit. They go to high level, and they are not stable there, so they jump back. And when they jump back, they emit light, photon, visible, or ultraviolet. In mercury case, many ultraviolets are produced, and these ultraviolets are absorbed by this powder, and that powder will give visible light. So it is like a type of wavelength shifter. And this is the reason why the tubelet glows. The tubelet glows because it receives energy from this globe in the form of photons, say, and this neon bulb also glows. I am holding the tester by metal and still it glows. It indicates that our neon bulb is getting energy from this globe by radiations, and that radiation is electromagnetic waves. And you know, wave and particle nature, photons and wave nature of light, electromagnetic waves, these waves are of very high frequency. How much high frequency? About 30 to 40 kilohertz. 30 to 40 kilohertz is quite high frequency, and inside the electrode has very high voltage. How much high voltage? About 10,000 to 20,000 volt. So 10 to 20 kV and frequency 30 to 40 kilohertz. By this only we can make sparks. So you can remember two things. You require high voltage, number one. You require high frequency, number two. Also you require high vacuum, and in that high vacuum you should have inert gases or mixture of them, helium, neon, argon like. So if you satisfy all these criteria, then only you can get this spark coming out, and plasma discharge is possible. If we touch by the hand, there is no danger at all. It is having no shock, but it appears to be very dangerous, because when I touch, I feel that some spark is going in my body, and it's psychology that whenever something spark-like comes, we always have a fear in mind. Even when tester glows, we always say there is danger, but it is not like that. Okay, thank you.